doing on the hood of a limo?
Maybe they haven't got no room on the inside.
You don't want Jaguars or Mercedes. You're talking jobs that cost $200,000, $300,000. The ones we sell them are unique.
Somebody stole a car from Wheels. I want to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Who are you?
We're teachers here.
We've just been traded from Harvard.
Yeah, for two math teachers and a first-round draft choice.
Don't do it. I'm telling you, you'll be sorry. Don't shoot!
To the most valuable cars in the world, and you can see any of them anytime in our parking lot.
Kid, but you're out of your league.
Oh, man, why do we have to work tonight?
Because Milkus and Friel are on vacation.
Yeah, but we got a double date.
So I'll call the two girls back and make it another night.
No, you don't understand.
Bo said double date.
That's four girls. Two for him, two for me.
Yeah, all right.
Car four, burglary in progress at 436 Crescent Drive.
4036 Crescent? What do we got there? Wheels! Come on, let's go!
And you say the car was taken from here?
Yeah.
All right. Wait here.
This is what they taught me at NYPD, so watch close.
Hey, we're not exactly inexperienced ourselves, you know.
Yeah, I know. Well, the important thing is to ask questions.
Why are we looking here when the car was taken from there?
Now, that's a good question. Because the area surrounding the crime can sometimes help nail the suspect. For instance, a cigarette butt, a match, stuff like that. A good criminal always takes a last look before he leaves. But sometimes, they forget to check outside the immediate area.
Huh.
That used to be somebody's juicy fruit.
Aha! But whose juicy fruit?
Hey, look at this. Matchsticks.
Aha! But whose matchsticks?
Exactly. Keep up the good work, guys. Hey, kid, how you doing? You all right? Did you get hurt?
No, I tried to stop him.
Oh, yeah, good citizen, huh? It's a good thing he didn't see you climb over that fence over there.
I didn't climb over the fence. I came in the front gate when I saw him trying to steal the car.
All right. What are you doing out so late?
Walking, that's all. Just walking.
What's your name?
Brad Grauman.
Rocky Nelson, nice to meet you. Go to Beverly Hills High, huh? It's a good school. What's the matter, something wrong?
Oh, no, nothing.
Okay, Brad, I'll see you around. Did a good job, pal. By the way, better tell your mother to fix your jacket. A tail like that in Beverly Hills could give the school a bad name, huh?
There's any clue around this place, it's right here in these bags.
Make sure Chester sees those clues.
What the hell is all this on my desk?
We thought you'd be impressed.
What is this? They're clues to lead to the apprehension of the car thief.
But this is garbage.
Ha ha! But whose garbage?
Now that's thinking.
Take those clues and shove them back in that bag. Clean this junk up before I get back.
I don't know, Rocky. Chester didn't think gathering all this evidence was such a good idea.
Well, he's wrong. This is a Beverly Hills High athletic pit, and that proves it. Now, that's a good clue.
Must be a clue to the car theft.
We found it. We should solve the case, like Rocky solved all those cases in New York.
Yeah, and maybe they'll make a movie of our life story.
And we'll be big enough to play the part.
Rocky says the key to being a good cop is you gotta have initiative.
Yeah, you gotta be pushy too.
I think you're terrific, Leslie.
Come on, Brad, I'm talking about the routine.
Your leaps are just fine. You just have to work on your pom-poms. I gotta go.
Come on, you guys, one more time.
Well, what do you think? Am I holding it right?
You look very intellectual to me. Excuse me, son, but this was in the Lost and Found. Is this your athletic pin?
Who are you?
We're teachers here.
I've never seen you before.
We've just been traded from Harvard.
Traded?
Yeah, for two math teachers and a first-round draft choice.
I'm Mr. Brandon. I teach philosophy. I love to think.
And I teach...
English.
Right, English.
That's not my button, guys.
Excuse me. Wasn't that Brett Grauman you were talking to? Do you know him?
Of course, he's my boyfriend. Who are you?
Well, I don't want anyone to know I'm here. I'm doing some preliminary scouting for Notre Dame.
Oh, well, you can watch Brad. He's right over there.
Well, we're interested in more than athletic ability. We like to know the whole person.
Brad's a very good citizen. He helps charities, works with little kids, you know, stuff like that.
Hi, Mr. Nelson. What's up?
Thank you very much. Could you excuse us a minute? Your lies didn't hold up so good. Somebody found a high school button inside the fence you climbed over at Wheels.
No, you're wrong.
I'm wrong? I hope your father's got a good lawyer. Maybe then you'll only get about 2 or 3 years.
Don't tell Dad. Please.
You know what I don't understand? Why does a kid like you steal a car?
No, I wasn't stealing the car. I was just gonna borrow it.
You know, you're a rotten car thief, but you're a worse liar.
I swear. The truth is, I was on a scavenger hunt.
A scavenger hunt for a $200,000 car?
This is Beverly Hills. You should see the rest of the list.
I can imagine. Look at this place. This isn't a high school, this is a country club.
Didn't you go to a high school?
Yeah, I went to one, but we didn't play baseball. We played Run for Your Life. Listen, I know you didn't steal the car, but you're gonna have to tell me everything you saw. Everything.
The man stealing the car.
Right.
I didn't get a good look at him, but the car that dropped him off was a limo.
A limo? Now I know I'm in Beverly Hills. Even the car thieves get driven to work.
I remember the license because it was small. It was 274. And it said Consular Corps.
Consular Corps? You're going to have to tell the police everything you saw.
They'll arrest me.
Look, you only got knocked down the first time. We want to make sure there's no next time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Oh, man, this is getting boring.
Bo.
Huh?
Rocky's leaving. Let's let him lead us to the next clue.
Nice try, boys, but it wasn't one of the kids that took the car. Let's go.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes. Hamill doesn't want anyone to know around here, but we're with the State Department. We're working on the Whitman case.
I didn't hear anything about a Whitman case.
Well, Hamill's a good man. He knows how to keep things under wraps, you know? Listen, check out a license plate for me. Counselor Corps 274.
You got it, sir.
Thank you.
Consular Corps? What the heck is that?
What's the matter with you? Haven't you ever been to summer camp?
No. Counselor Corps is what they put on the license plate of people who come from foreign countries.
How come it doesn't say that on my gardener's license plate?
Sir, that car belongs to the Consulate of Zilan.
Can you give me a list of their personnel?
Well, I have to use federal computer time.
Look, I know it's expensive, but just charge it to Lieutenant Hamill. It'll be okay.
What are you guys doing in my office?
We just thought we'd come by and see if there's any openings. Maybe we could join the police force. Hey, Brad, I'm glad you decided to take my advice and call the police.
Yeah, I called them. I told them what I told you, and they arrested me.
What? What are you kidding?
I should arrest you for withholding evidence. That's a felony. You could get 5 years.
You hit it? 5 years for withholding evidence.
With all we've got, they could put us away for life. Or longer.
Look, Mr. Nelson, you have to help me. With this on my record, I'm never going to get into college.
It's all right, Brad. Don't worry about it. I'll do whatever I can to help you. I promise you. Hamill, are you on drugs or what? Does this kid look like a car thief to you?
I got to admit, it's disappointing. Brad comes from one of our finest families. But the fact is, he was breaking and entering. And when we catch his accomplice...
What accomplice?
The one that got away with a car. You don't believe that nonsense about a limo, do you?
It's true.
Take him away.
Don't worry, Brad. Now, as usual, wrong, wrong, wrong.
Here's the information you requested.
Thank you. Good work.
What was all that about?
The information for that man from the State Department.
What is this?
We just want you to know that the Beverly Hills Patrol cooperates with the police department.
So, here's all the evidence we found.
What do you want?
I came to help you.
No, thanks. I'll end up in a dungeon.
Listen, you're the one that did something stupid to get yourself in here. Don't start blaming other people.
I never would have hurt that car. I used to park cars at Wheels. I know how to drive them.
Look, all I wanted to do was drive the car to the party, show it to everybody, and then bring it right back. Big deal. I didn't mean any harm.
Who else was at that party that was on the scavenger hunt that could back up your story?
Forget it. I don't want to get anybody else involved.
What if it's the only way?
Forget it.
All right. Remember, kid, no matter what you think, I'm still on your side.
In 2 days.
I know that. But you don't want Jaguars or Mercedes. You're talking jobs that cost $200,000-$300,000.
Quite correct. The people in my neighboring countries can buy those cars anywhere. The ones we sell them are unique.
Well, unique isn't easy to come by. I need a little time.
2 days, Mr. Dillon.
To deliver those cars for the flight to Zalon.
I'm sorry, sir. You cannot go in there. He is very busy. You need an appointment. I'm sorry, sir. You cannot go in there.
This won't take long. I'm sorry, this is an emergency. If you take as long as your guards did letting me in, this could get very serious. I'm surprised you don't smell it.
I beg your pardon.
I don't smell anything.
Who are you, young man?
I'm sorry. Beverly Hills Environmental Control. You have a high contamination reading here.
What? Well, what is the trouble?
A tanker overturned a couple of blocks away.
There are tankers driving through Beverly Hills?
You know how it is. The driver was taking a tour of movie star homes. Listen, if you have anything delicate around here, you know, like statues or expensive cars out back, you should cover them because the carbonic dust will eat the paint right off. Have a nice day. So, how do you like our country so far?
A very generous people. Especially our friends here in Beverly Hills.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm. They've donated tons of medical supplies to the needy people of Ceylon.
With all the doctors they got out here, it's a wonder if they got any supplies left at all. It's a joke. I was only kidding. Listen, I can see you're busy. You continue with your work, and I'll check out the premises for you.
My man will take care of that.
No, you're a guest in our country. I couldn't let you do that. I got it.
Know that you were with Beverly Hills Patrol. Neither did I. I'm so sorry, Mr. Nelson.
I'm sorry, too.
But Mr. Long assures me that you were just making a check of our security system.
We'll be getting out of your way, sir.
Congratulate your guard for me. He throws a great sucker punch.
He used his gun butt. My men are armed, Mr. Nelson.
I'm sorry, sir. Won't happen again.
Tell him I'll catch him on the rebound. Maybe we could do it again, face to face sometime.
Rocky, will you just be quiet and come on? Damn it, your prying is gonna cost the Beverly Hills Patrol their license. Now stay away from here. I carried you in from the garage, I looked inside, two limos, that's it.
Are you sure?
Hey, what is this? Am I not a reliable enough witness for you?
It's not that. He must have moved the cars.
Hey, Rock. I got enough problems dealing with the grief you cause our own people. Us Americans. You are not going to branch out and wreak havoc on foreign governments.
It's my fault that kid's in trouble. I'm gonna do whatever I have to do to help him. Just want you to know. Okay, Hunk. Do your stuff.
What's the matter with you dogs? Come on! We've got to get back to this gate!
is in where we'll be safe.
Go away! What an ugly dog!
Bingo!
Sinatra?
Hey, Rocky.
Hey, Mr. Martin.
You all right? You comfortable?
Sure.
Good. Now, I hate to disturb you, but every phone in the main house is out. And I have to make a phone call to an old friend.
One of the guys in the old Rat Pack, huh?
Doesn't happen to be a guy. It's a brand new girl I met about 2 hours ago. In fact, want me to find out if she has a sister available?
No, thanks. Every available sister I ever met looks like she belongs in a different family. Forget it, Rocky. Not today. You're getting nothing from the studio. Come here. You know what I need? I need one of those super jazzy antique classic cars for Chester.
An antique classy car. That's a good one. I love it.
Well, wouldn't you want to see Chester drive to his own birthday party in a Bordini or a Lagonda?
Sure I would. Yeah, if it was his birthday. But coming from you, no way.
Debbie, Brooke, Sammy, Frank, Liza, Dean.
Okay, wait right here. Hello, Annie, it's Donald. What's this about Chester's birthday? Oh. Oh, well, good. Rocky's throwing a party. Oh, yeah, I'll see you later. All right.
Well, why don't you giving it to me straight?
I'm telling you that these car thefts must stop now. This department's prestige and reputation are on the line. I'm talking your jobs here. Looks like any fool can come into Beverly Hills and steal an expensive car without any interference from us. And once stolen, we never recover it. This scene has got to stop. Lieutenant Hamill. Yes, sir. I know. An epidemic? Look, you must understand that 90% of the expensive cars in the country are right here in Beverly Hills. Yes, sir. Okay, no excuses. We are in a pressure cooker, and I don't like it. And if this problem isn't solved, you're not going to like it any better. Any questions?
Lieutenant, do you expect us to check every license and every car, expensive car that we see?
Yes. Anytime you spot a suspicious-looking person around any of these cars, investigate them. I want these car thefts stopped. My head is on the block, and I don't want it chopped off. Now move, hit the street.
Hey, I'm glad you guys showed up.
We were afraid you wouldn't see us.
What, are you kidding? That's like missing Century City.
Why'd you want us here?
I'm giving you guys one more chance. This time you better not mess it up.
How can we help?
Well, you heard about all the custom car ripoffs, right?
Yeah.
Well, I borrowed this car from the studio. It costs $110,000. I need somebody to watch it.
You think someone would try to steal it from here?
You know a better place? They did it before. Now remember, if somebody tries to snatch that car, you grab them. There's a big reward for you guys.
That'll change it.
Coming down the road, do you remember what was happening over there? The two of them were head to head like this, right?
Mr. Shapiro. Can I talk to you a minute?
Do you know me?
Shelley Shapiro, superstar agent extraordinaire. Everybody knows who you are. I'm Rocky Nelson.
I'm afraid I never heard of you.
Exactly. But if I had somebody like you handling me, who knows how far I could go.
You a member here?
No, not yet. Just looking the place over. A friend of mine told me about it, Mario. Andretti, that is.
Oh, well then you belong to our branch back east.
right, sure. Yeah, I got tired of all the slush. I figured I'd give palm trees and bikinis a shot, you know what I mean?
Yeah. What do you drive?
Did you see the Clinet outside with the two big fellas standing in front of it?
Yeah. Who are those two guys?
Oh, they're just work for me to keep an eye on the car. Oh. Listen, I know this isn't the place to talk business, Shelley, baby, but I'm an actor. I have these pictures, a resume, you know?
Tell me what else you own, Mr. Nelson.
You mean besides the one outside?
Mm-hmm. Surely you don't own just one classic car.
Of course not. Of course. Actually, I'm looking for a Countach to add to my collection.
Like the one that was stolen here from Wheels.
Exactly. You know where I can get one of those?
Not offhand, but I'd be glad to ask around.
Good.
Another dented fender, please. We name all our drinks after car parts.
Oh, but you know that from the branch back east.
Right, of course. I'll have a camshaft.
So early in the morning?
Yeah, well, when I was 10 years old, my father used to let me sip on his axle bearings. Is that guy over there a member here?
We'll come like this, all of a sudden hit on the brake. I don't know what happened. I almost fell out the door.
Floyd Dillon. No, he's been kind of adopted by the club. You know, he's an ace mechanic on classics.
Really? Floyd Dillon.
Mm-hmm.
I can always use a good mechanic. Excuse me, 1 minute. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Floyd Dillon. I'd like to talk to you about some cars.
You at the Zelanian Embassy? The environmental guy, huh?
Oh, right. Well, environmental control is my job. Classic cars are my life.
How do you make enough money working for the government to afford classics?
Some of the people I investigate are very generous sometimes. I hear you're an expert with oldies but goodies.
I know enough.
Maybe you could help me find a Countach.
Sorry. Too hard to come by. Excuse me.
Oh, look at this. It's even got a shortwave radio.
It's perfect for short guys like Rocky.
I never seen ammo boiling like that before.
Here's Wheels. That's where that Countach was stolen from.
Hey, look at those two big guys by that Clinet. They don't look like they belong here. Let's go.
Yeah.
Man, even the axles are chrome. Uh-oh. We got trouble. Rocky was right. They're gonna try to take the car.
We'll see about that.
All right, you two. Hands up.
The old button hook on three.
Don't try anything funny. We're calling the cops.
You want cops? I'll give you cops. You two are under arrest. And that car goes back to its rightful owner.
Nelson will be back in a moment.
Okay, you got it. Goodbye. Come in. What is it, Chester?
Look, Lieutenant, I don't like the idea of you arresting two of my men for standing in a parking lot.
Did they tell you they were standing next to a $110,000 stolen car? And that they manhandled a couple of my detectives when they were approached for questioning?
What?
And that the car had a phony license plate? The type car they use for movies, which was reported stolen from a certain studio lot. Now, how do you suppose a car like that got over there next to Bo and Kurt?
Well,
and before you answer, it is illegal for a car with phony license plates to drive on a public street. Anything else?
Then you do remember me, huh, Dillon? Good. Listen, some guy wants to sell me his Clin A. I want you to take a look at it for me. Huh? Well, I'll leave it outside my house. 2879 Camden Place. This afternoon's good. Thanks, Dylan. Listen, I never got a chance to thank you for bailing Bo and Kurt out of jail.
Then don't. It was the only way I could be sure that Bo and Kurt would be able to get their hands on you.
Turn around and go away.
Donald, I need that car again.
Chester's gonna have to live without it. I'm not gonna miss the party because I'm in jail.
Come on, huh? Nobody's going to jail.
You gonna leave now or I'm gonna have to use force.
What?
Turn around.
All right, don't hit me, don't hit me.
I'm empty, I gotta pick up the electrical and take it to location.
Keep quiet. From now on, when you understand something, just nod.
When I get my hands on Rocky, I'm gonna beat him to a pulp.
You're not gonna do anything to him.
Why?
Because when I get through with him, there won't be anything left.
Hey, there's that car we got busted for trying to steal.
It's supposed to be back at the studio.
Someone really must be stealing it this time.
If we get this car back, Chester will be happy with us.
We got the Clin A. I'm on my way to the airport now.
Must be getting chased. I wonder by who. This is making me crazy. I gotta see who's chasing us.
We can't lose them. You're crazy.
It figures. One time I don't want them, they show up.
Lose them.
Need a jet plane to catch that car.
Quiet. What are you looking at? Where Rogers used to talk to Trigger. All right. You're cuter than Trigger. Oh, great. Just what I needed. Gasoline. There's a spark within 100 yards with fried chicken. There's a god for dogs, you better start barking. I was kidding. Pray quiet.
Hey,
you.
You.
Easy, girl. Back off.
Car's too hot now. I'm getting out of here. And she's coming with me. You try anything, you get it back stuff.
Easy, Don. This whole trunk is full of gas. You shoot that thing, there won't be anything left of any of us to stuff.
And don't do anything stupid.
Right, I won't, but don't shoot.
Hurry up. We gotta find him somewhere.
Get him, Hunk!
Special day for the Beverly Hills Patrol.
This is exciting. I feel just like Goldie Hawn and Private Benjamin.
This one is a biggie. Our client is the city of Beverly Hills. All the media will be at the news conference.
That guy Cirillo gonna be there too?
Of course. It's this country's medical supplies he's seeing off. And you are manning the phones today.
It's okay with me. I'll give Annie a break. I don't mind.
I'm glad I get to work in the field today.
I didn't know you liked farming.
All right, let's go.
Yeah, what'd you forget?
Well, I don't like the way your eyes lit up when you heard Cirillo's name. Now, you've hounded him and the Zilan Council enough. And this is a big day for him and Beverly Hills. And I don't want you to screw it up.
Right.
Now, I'm going to the airport. It would be a pleasant occasion without incident, right?
Right.
And now, to make a long story short...
You're a little too late for that, but I got your point. Have a pleasant day without incident. From me. Boss. KLAG News, Beverly Hills Patrol. I got a scoop for you. Pia and Bert are getting married. That's right, they're gonna elope. If you pick me up here, I'll take you where they are.
This is the 6 o'clock local news reporting from its mobile truck of the Goodwill flight to Zilan. The Chamber of Commerce in Beverly Hills has concluded the successful medical supply drive for that country. Many dignitaries, celebrities, and well-wishers are here, along with the ambassador to Zilan, Holly Cirillo, to celebrate this happy send-off. It is indeed a rewarding experience to watch these massive crates of
Annie, why don't you stay with the media? Bo and Kurt, you cover the airport entrance. We don't want any civilians out here on the field.
Bound for the needy people of Zilan. Case after case of antibiotics and other medicines to help the deprived and unwell of that far-off land.
What it is?
Hold it.
KLAG News.
Okay.
And so the people of Zilan extend their gratitude to the people of Beverly Hills.
Can you let me off over here, please? If Pia sees me with you, she's gonna be mad.
People of Zilan are comforted by your generosity and the knowledge that we are in your minds and in your hearts.
You are to take up the patrol helicopter to cover the ceremony from the air. Chester!
You still know how to fly a chopper.
Oh, man, it's just like riding a bike. You never forget.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go through our pre-flight checklist. Cirillo wants us to take off the second this stuff is loaded. He wants us out of here fast.
I don't know about this, man.
Come on, Curtin.
chopper's right over here.
Are you sure you remember how to fly one of these things?
It'll be fun. Just relax.
That's what you told me before we crashed the hand glider.
I would also like to acknowledge the generosity of the Beverly Hills merchants who help in this community endeavor.
Let me go find Bert and Pierre for you. Hold this.
Tears well up in my eyes when I picture the children of Ceylon benefiting from the generosity of the people of Beverly Hills. So many of you have opened your hearts to us.
What
to name a few, Celeste Levinson.
Hey! Will you...
That'll be quite enough, Mr. Nelson.
I love your version of penicillin.
Let's discuss this. Move and move quickly.
Hey, you got some haul here, huh?
Quite true. 12 automobiles this trip, and next month we plan to accept the generosity of the people of West Ham.
Won't be able to. You're going to jail.
I'm going to Ceylon. And it appears you're going with me. As long as I choose to keep you alive.
You don't understand. In 5 minutes, this place is going to be crawling with cops.
I have diplomatic immunity. They can't do anything to me. I'm going home.
I got news for you, pal. Home may be coming to you. I called your government. I told them what you've been doing, and they're not very happy about it.
Will you relax? We're only 300 feet up.
Good. Then I'll only make a little splat when I hit the ground.
Yeah, like the 6.9 on a Richter scale.
You are good at lying. A good bluff, as they say.
I am not lying, and I'm not bluffing. The Zelanian police are coming to get you. Now, I'll give you a choice. You can either do time in one of our American prisons or take the punishment they dish out in your country. What is it now? They're still chopping off hands for stealing?
Only one hand.
One hand? The liberals must have took over. Look.
Got no room on the inside.
Protection.
I demand political asylum.
All right, all right. Welcome to America. Although it's not as pretty from behind bars, it'll have to do.
Now what? State penitentiary?
You can go home, kid. We caught the thieves.
Is that the best you can do, Hamill? Don't you think you owe the kid an apology?
Look, Rocky, he admitted to me he was trying to take the car for himself. I could put him away for attempted car theft. And as for you, you're lucky that the studio's insurance paid for the other car. Or have you forgotten it's because of you the other car was blown up?
That's the trouble with you cops. You don't care about people, just property.
Hey, that's not nice, and you're wrong. These guys put their life on the line every day to protect people like you and me. And don't you forget it.
Rocky, that's not necessary.
Yes, it is.
No, you're right, Mr. Nelson. Look, I'm sorry, Lieutenant.
Maybe the next time you think about taking somebody else's property, you'll remember the time you spent in here, huh?
Don't worry. I don't want to see the inside of another police department or jail ever again.
Okay, go home. Get out of here.
I guess he really is a good kid.
You know, Hamill, sometimes I think there's hope for you.
We wish you the best. I hate surprises.
Who's responsible for this? Don't everybody talk at the same time. I would like an answer.
Well, I'm afraid it was all Rocky's idea.
Is this true?
I'm afraid so.
Thanks, Rocky, for caring about me.
I knew it.
Happy birthday.